Welcome to EEMS 210. This video introduces users to the hydrodynamic and salinity options and features in the EFDC Explorer interface. Within the hydrodynamic parameter settings, there are 8 different groupings. These are numerical options, turbulence, roughness, shallow water, wind forcing, Coriolis effect, density effects factor, and vegetation. In this video, we will also take a look at the setup of the salinity module. Let's get started. The numerical solution options window in the hydrodynamics module allows the users to select numerical solution schemes to be used in EFDC+. The two-time level and three-time level solutions are primary, and allow the users to select the method to be used for numerical simulation. If using the three-time level option, the user must specify the momentum solution option. Upwind difference is the recommended momentum advection scheme. Central difference and experimental upwind difference are experimental and not recommended for most applications. The trapezoidal correction scheme is typically set from 3 to 5. And 4 by default. The two-time level solution is the most robust solution technique and is recommended. The two-time level solution also has the advantage of supporting dynamic time stepping, which allows the model time step to be varied in the simulation. The turbulence options for EFDC Plus are divided into three groupings: turbulent diffusion, turbulent intensity, and momentum correction. The turbulence option window provides the computational options for the horizontal and vertical eddy viscosities and diffusivities. The parameters and options have been grouped according to which dimension they are used for, specifically the horizontal and vertical dimensions. The horizontal kinematic eddy viscosity and diffusivity options frame provides a drop-down menu which is used to enable the horizontal momentum diffusion capabilities of EFDC+. If the disable horizontal momentum diffusion option is selected, the horizontal momentum diffusion is set to the background constant horizontal eddy viscosity value specified by the user. When activate horizontal momentum diffusion with Smagorinsky, wall drag, or water column diffusion is selected, then the full horizontal momentum diffusion, wall drag, and water column diffusion can be optionally computed. The water column diffusion option also applies diffusivities to all constituent transport, which includes salinity and temperatures. This option should be used when simulating a very uniform system where constituent transport is needed. The vertical eddy viscosities and diffusivities frame allows the user to set the time advanced filter and vertical eddy viscosity, as well as the vertical molecular diffusivity. The maximum magnitude for diffusivity terms allows the users to set the maximum kinematic eddy viscosity, as well as the maximum eddy diffusivity. Next, let's take a look at the turbulent intensity tab. Generally, only the sub-options for standard scheme will need to be changed. The user can select one of four sub-options, including the original Galperin function, the Galperin 1988 stability function, the Kantha and Claisen 1994 scheme, or the Kantha 2003 scheme. The vertical turbulence limiting options provide a drop-down menu that allows the user to choose from three options with regards to the maximum gradient Richardson number: node length scale and maximum Richardson number limitation, to limit the Richardson number in the stability function only, and finally, to limit both the length scale and maximum Richardson number. When using multi-layer models and vertical turbulence is limiting, the limit length scale and limit maximum Richardson number option provides greater model stability and can help reduce the likelihood of a model crash. The wall proximity function allows the user three options: no wall proximity effect on the turbulence, to be parabolic over depth wall proximity, and finally, open channel wall proximity. The turbulence closure constants may be changed after checking the Modify checkbox. However, these constants should not be changed without good justification. Next, let's take a look at the Momentum Correction tab. Further turbulence modification options are also available under the Momentum Correction tab. These options allow various momentum corrections, which may be enabled with the Momentum Correction Options checkbox. The Roughness tab provides options for configuring the initial bottom roughness. EMS supports an enhanced approach for calculating the drag coefficient. In the initial bottom roughness frame, the calculation method for the drag coefficient and a temporally constant bottom roughness can be configured. EFDC Plus features an enhanced approach for calculating the drag coefficient, which has been developed to capture the profile of vertical velocities at both small and large scales. The user can also select the EFDC Plus version 8 approach, and the approach used by the original versions of EFDC. The user is able to assign the initial conditions for the bottom roughness parameters when the Assign button is pressed. As with the assignment of bathymetry, the roughness values can be modified for all cells in the grid or for a subset defined by a polygon. Values can also be set to a constant value or can be set based on scattered points stored in an XYZ text file. For now, we can simply set up a constant bottom roughness value in all grid cells. Next, we will take a look at the shallow water and wetting and drying options. These wetting and drying options in EE10 are simplified compared to previous releases of EEMS. The three options include: do not allow cells to wet and dry, use wet and dry with nonlinear iterations, and use wet and dry with nonlinear iterations and face masking option. The dry depth defines at what depth a cell can be considered dry. If no wetting and drying is allowed, then all model cells will be forced to be wet. The dry step is used when there is a wet cell that is isolated or perched and also has a very small depth. In this case, after a certain number of time steps set by the user, EFDC will drain water from the cell. EFDC will continue to keep track of the cell and the volume of water removed from the system in order to calculate mass balance. The wet depth, specified in the boundary conditions withdrawal wet depth frame, sets the minimum water depth for water to be withdrawn from the cell by a boundary condition. Water depth below the specified value will prevent water from being withdrawn. This value must be greater than the dry depth. The next component of the hydrodynamics module we will look at is wind forcing. Especially in water bodies with large surface areas, transfer of momentum from the wind to the water body represents an important term for understanding mixing dynamics. Three different surface drag formulations are available in EFDC Plus. The user can select the original EFDC surface drag method, the original relative UV method, which adjusts wind speed based on the velocity of the water, the Hirschbach 2011 approach, which uses a linear relationship between wind speed and the drag coefficient. The final option, the Core 3.6 simplified approach, uses an iterative approach based on the assumption of neutral atmospheric conditions. The number of wind speed and direction time series in the WSIR.IMP file are displayed in the number of series. The data series editor for winds can be quickly opened using the edit button. The wind series requires time, wind speed, and wind direction. The location of a wind station can be specified using latitude and longitude or UTM coordinates. The height of the anemometer is also specified in the parameters tab. EEMS provides a flexible station weighting methodology for map files when handling multiple atmospheric, wind, or ice series. Each of these time series has a corresponding map file when there are multiple series. Calculation of the station weighting is handled by EE and the input files for EFDC. The series weighting provides users with a simple tool for managing the data and stations for wind, ice, and atmospheric data. This approach allows EE to display the stations in a grid format with a quality index that indicates how the user rates each time series and time block within that series. The default quality indices have been set by EE after selecting the Generate by Time Series Data button. EE automatically generates the quality index with the maximum value of 1 for the defaults. The user now needs to provide each time series with a quality index from 0 to 1. This weighting is based on user's judgment of the quality of the data series based on various factors. If the user knows of no problems with the series, then they would give it a rating of 1. However, often various factors will influence the quality of a time series and cause the user to downgrade the series. This could be due to the station's distance from the model domain or an intervening geographic feature. In this case, a lower value for the quality index will be selected, and if another time series is available for that period with a higher weighting value, it will have a greater impact on the model. The weighting map that EE generates is calculated based on the inverse squared distances from the cells to the station and the qualitative coefficient for each time series. It includes the number of maps and the corresponding blocks of weighting coefficients. Sheltering coefficients function as a multiplier for the wind speed. Generally, values range from 0 to 1, but can also exceed 1 based on the user specifications. The sheltering coefficient values are configured in a similar manner to bathymetry and roughness values, where the user can specify a constant value for all cells, use an XYZ file, or change a subset of cells using a polygon file. The Coriolis effect can be optionally included in EFDC Plus models. The Coriolis effect window allows users to determine the Coriolis factor by setting the latitude in degrees, which is the latitude of the midpoint of the model domain. The Coriolis factor is automatically computed based on the latitude provided. The density effects factor allows users to modify the timing for transitioning to full density effects in the model. Buoyancy can be adjusted with a buoyancy factor that must be between 0 and 1, with 0 being no buoyancy influence and 1 being full buoyancy influence. The vegetation model in EFDC Plus can be used to describe flow resistance related to rigid vegetation or other structures, such as trees, pilings, or aquatic plants. Let's have a look at how the vegetation submodule functions in EFDC Explorer. Here, the user can set the primary computational options for enabling the vegetation feature, use vegetation resistance, or use vegetation with diagnostics. The vegetation class settings are available via the Modify button, which provides a user interface for the data that is needed for the veg.imp file. The total number of classes currently defined are shown in the Number of Classes box. First, the user should specify the number of vegetation classes needed. Enter the number of vegetation classes into the input box and press Enter. The grid will be expanded to accommodate the desired number of classes. All of the input parameters required by EFDC Plus are shown with a couple of exceptions. The beta 1 and beta 2 variables are not actually used but are included in the list. The veg.imp file must have data in those columns, but they are not actually used by EFDC Plus. The other exceptions are the ID and description fields. They are only used by EFDC Explorer. The ID field is used to match vegetation classes to polygon IDs. To automatically set the vegetation map that is needed for input via the lxly.imp file. The description field is used only for labeling. The Apply Overlays button uses the vegetation class ID field and matches it to input polygon IDs. The Apply Overlays dialog functions in a similar way to other Apply Cell properties via polygon interfaces that we've encountered so far. If a single polygon with no ID is provided, then the default class will be assigned to all cells or only cells inside a polygon. The files containing one or more polygons in the same file need to be opened. Once the file has been read, the polygon IDs will be matched to the vegetation class IDs. If any vegetation classes do not have any defining polygons, the user will be notified. Salinity in water impacts the density and therefore hydrodynamic processes. The parameters and settings discussed with regards to the hydrodynamics module also impact salinity, and these include the settings for turbulence, roughness, wind forcing, and density effect factor. Generally, any parameters which control horizontal or vertical turbulence closure will impact hydrodynamics and salinity. The salinity module can be activated by right-clicking on the modules. The salinity module in EFDC Explorer includes the initial and boundary time series. As stated before, transport based on salinity concentration is controlled primarily by the hydrodynamic parameters. Initial conditions can be set as a constant value or as spatially varying. Salinity concentrations can also be downloaded from online sources. The Use Spatially Varying Initial Conditions checkbox must be checked in order to use spatially varying initial conditions. Assigning spatially varying or constant initial conditions is done through the Apply Cell properties via Polygon Dialog. As with many of the Apply Cell properties dialogs, properties can be applied to all grid cells or only to selected grid cells using a polygon file. Additionally, cell properties can be applied for all layers or only for a specific layer. Initial conditions can be set to constant values, interpolated horizontally from XYZ data files, or can be applied based on vertical profiles. Interpolation options can be customized as well. The Time Series Data Editor can also be accessed through the Salinity Parameters dialog. The Time Series Editor for Salinity offers functionality similar to that of the Time Series Editor for Flow. For more information on the functionality of the Time Series Editor, check out the EEMS 120 video. Thank you for watching. You can view the next EEMS training video by following the link below.